I found out one thing with the left-sided people, if they can put a candle near their left Swadhisthana, a little far, and put one candle before the photograph, and put left hand towards the photograph, and right hand on the Mother Earth, it works. And the candle at the back should be kept a little far away, because it makes sounds, it goes this way, that way, it burns. Those who have been taking drugs, not LSD but other drugs, which are drowsy people who feel sleepy, whose brains are destroyed by drug, all those people can benefit a lot by this. Do it every day. Going into drugs, you never felt you are surrendered to drugs, never felt that. Which was something that was going to kill you completely. You know, so many people are killed, so many are dying, but you wanted to do that, I don't know, because your ego said, all right, go ahead, try this. You will be the one who, nothing will happen to you. That's the ego suggests. So you did it. All right, doesn't matter. Whatever has happened, let us clear it out, because we are seekers. So those who have really felt one in the lecture without any questioning should know that they are doing well. Those who were questioning, reflecting, should know they have ego. And those who are dozing out should know that they are left-sided. Left side is worse than the right side, because the right side can be easily corrected, it shows. It shows outside. People don't like it, such a person is criticized, everybody says he's egoistical, he is that, everybody knows that such a person goes out, like Hitler. But the left-sided person, you see, is very pitiable and you have very great pity for such a person, you sympathize, and you get lost with that person. They are more dangerous and difficult to be cured, very difficult. So it's not an easy task, we have to work it out. I'm trying my level best, you should also help me. I was thinking that if you can start using little oil for your head, will be a good idea in the night. As Sahaja Yogis, you should. I think the hairstyle should be changed for Sahaja Yogis. This modern fashionable style won't suit us, because this will, you'll have all bald heads one day, I can tell you, and you will see the Sahasrara with a big dimple here. Better use some nice coconut oil. Rub in your head nicely, and in the night and in the morning, after all, it doesn't show much. And comb your hair in a proper way. Because also I think if your dresses are like boots, your hair are like boots, then the boots will take over thinking, oh, this is a boot sitting down here, better take hold of that boot. So dress up in a way, shouldn't have hair on your forehead at all. Keep it straight, make it nice, and have it absolutely clean foreheads. We are Sahaja Yogis, we have to change our dresses, we have to change our styles. We cannot become fashionable like these stupid punks. So we are a type, by our hairstyle people should know that these are Sahaja Yogis. So before you start getting bald, better try putting some oil in your head. That's one very important thing the Sahaja Yogis have to do. They can take vibrated oil if you like, and I think olive oil is good, but better than olive oil, I find it is coconut oil is better for the growth of the hair. But sometimes you can also put almond oil, is also good, almond oil for you, because if you have any problem that you feel exhausted or your nerves need attention, you are nervous type of person, then almond oil is good for you. And for people who have teeth which are troubling them, they must look after them. No use going to the dentist, because dentists create problems. Simple thing is to use olive oil and some salt and rub it on your gums nicely every day before sleeping. That will keep your teeth all right. You'll be amazed, till today I have not been to any dentist. Never been to a dentist, and I hope I won't go to a dentist. So, but one thing is that that I have certain bad habits. One of them is that I brush my teeth quite often. But don't use electrical brushes and all that, but use brushes or use your fingers. The best way is to rub with the salt and the oil. It's very good for you. And then allow the whole thing to come out and then wash your feet. Then the third thing I find in Europe, that you people do not clear your throats and your tongues, which is another thing very much against Vishuddhi. And that must be one of the reasons why your Vishuddhis are bad. So though it is not in fashionable here in the West, but very important thing is to put your two fingers in the mouth and rub your fingers, not the thing, fingers, and clean your tongue in such a way that everything comes out in the morning. It's important because that accumulates and then it rots. So this has to be done. And maybe that you might think that this is doing you make a noise and all that, doesn't matter. You have to clear out your throat. And that's how you will keep your Vishuddhis very clear. This is one of the things. And another thing is that you must always use water as much as possible for washing when you go for your morning ablution. Water must be used. The paper is a very dirty and unhygienic habit. Very dirty and unhygienic habit. But even if you use paper, you must use water after that. It's very important that all the time the water should be used as much as possible. For Sahaja Yogis, it is a very, very important thing.